वॉट वॉज द साइन रूल? ए अपॉन साइन ए
अपॉन साइन ए इक्वल्स
इज इक्वल्स टू
बी ओवर बी साइन ए
साइन बी इज इक्वल्स टू सी ओवर साइन सी. एंड यू कुड जस्ट रेसिप्रोकल इट ऑल्सो. यू कुड राइट इट लाइक दिस, साइन ए अपॉन ए इज इक्वल्स टू साइन बी अपॉन बी इज इक्वल्स टू साइन सी अपॉन सी. ओके, एनी वेज यू वॉन्ट टू यूज इट यू कैन यूज इट. ओके, नाउ लेट्स लुक एट द कोसाइन रूल. इन द कोसाइन रूल रिमेंबर दैट इफ यू हैव कॉस ए, ठीक है, देन वी टेक द सम ऑफ द स्क्वायर्स ऑफ द एडजेसेंट साइड. द एडजेसेंट साइड्स आर बी एंड सी. द सम ऑफ द स्क्वायर्स ऑफ द एडजेसेंट साइड माइनस द स्क्वायर ऑफ द ऑपोजिट साइड डिवाइडेड बाई टू टाइम्स द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द एडजेसेंट साइड. ओके, नाउ लेट्स लुक एट देन कॉस बी. ओके, वट आर द एडजेसेंट साइड्स ऑफ कॉस बी? For angle B, the adjacent sides are
C and A.
So that would
C and
be
A.
A square plus C square. Okay. What would be in minus? The opposite is B square upon 2 times the product of the adjacent sides, AC. Okay. Then let's look at the third one. So now you'll tell me what will cos C be. Cos C would become the adjacent sides A and B. कहाँ चले गए? So A square plus B square minus C
minus
square
C
upon
two A.
Okay. Now let's do the derivation of it. Okay, let's do the derivation of it. Let's say I drop a perpendicular out here. Okay? This is my x, so this will be my a minus x. Let's say this is the height. Now, I'll apply Pythagoras theorem, let's say out here. So if I apply Pythagoras theorem here, it will become what? B square plus h square is equals to x square, right guys?
Yeah.
And then if we apply the Pythagoras theorem here, it is a c square plus a square minus x square is equals to what did I do? X square b square plus h square. Hey, come on guys, I have written all wrong and you all did not even stop me. What is Pythagoras theorem? Hypotenuse square is equals to side square plus side square. Likewise, here also hypotenuse square is equals to side square plus side square. Now we subtract both of them. Now we subtract both the equation. So it becomes a b square minus c square. H square cancels out. X square minus. This will become a square plus x square minus 2ax. Open the brackets. Okay, if we open the brackets, what are we going to get? X square minus a square minus x square plus 2ax. X square and x square cancels out. Now this is x, which is the base in terms of angle C. Okay. So if I take another color and write down cos of angle C is equals to the adjacent side by the hypotenuse. My dear fellows, where are you all? So x is equals to b cos c Now I'm going to put the value of x here and see I get my answer. My derivation is done. Is equals to minus a square, okay, plus 2ab cos c. That means if I rearrange it, cos c is equals to b square plus a square minus c square upon 2ab, which is nothing but this value. Okay, but you don't need to learn the derivation. You just need to know how to apply the formula. I do the derivation so that, you know, by chance, if you forget the formula anytime, you should be able to derive the formula and you should be able to do the question. Okay, so now I'm writing the formula once more so that you all can jot it down, and then we will start some questions on it. So we have it here. This is any triangle ABC. So here we have an ABC. The sides opposite to them are opposite to angle AA, opposite to angle BB, opposite to angle CC. And our sine rule says that A upon sine A is equals to B upon sine B is equals to C upon sine C. Okay, and then we have our cos rule. Okay, so our cos rule becomes cos A. If it is a cos A, it will become a B square plus C square minus A square divided by 2BC, and cos B will become A square plus C square minus B square divided by 2AC, and cos C would become A square plus B square minus C square divided by 2AB. Okay, so you all can jot the formula down.